this video is going to concentrate on programming the action list to give you all of the views I've demonstrated in other videos. I tend to stick to 1 for bass, 2 for drums, 3 for acoustic, 4 for electric, 5 for keyboards, 6 for samplers if I'm using samplers, 7 for backing vocals, 8 for lead vocals, 9 I use an effects rack, which is pretty useful, and 0 gives me the final outputs. So 1 to 0 on the keyboard. I'm also going to transfer that onto the Mackie via CSI and show you how to do that. I'm going to try not to put too much into one video. What I'm doing here, bringing in track templates from buttons, something else I want to teach, but it's going to be too much, I think, for one video. What we are going to learn this video is how to program the output buses and how to route them and how to get them to appear every time you press 0 on your keyboard as a hotkey. That will be the view that you get. And essentially 1 to 0 covers all of the views. There are other mods like Control A, Command A, which is showing me the buses just now, and Control Command A giving you all of the tracks or global view, which converts onto the Mackie on the global view button. So there's the bass, the drums, 1, 2, etc. But notice that the view is of the recorded tracks and the buses and the output buses. So you're not scrolling across a page to find where the final output or anything like that is. You're just looking directly at the whole thing from where the sound source is to the output in one view. Adding modifiers, and I've got a structured way of using modifiers, which I'm going to demonstrate to, expands the way or the options of views you can have. So you can view anything at the touch of one button or a button with a modifier. We're only talking about 1 to 0 with 4 modifier keys, and that's just on the keyboard. It's even simpler if you get onto the controller. So on the Mackie controller, I've just got bass, drums, same layout as the keys. Obviously, I've only got 8 buttons here, but the row of 8 buttons underneath are also labeled. So I've just followed the labeling system of the rows underneath. So there's my lead vocals, that's the last one. My outputs are on outputs. Buses show me just the bus tracks involved in this track. And then audio tracks just shows me the recording tracks or actual tracks. And there's the global view button that shows me everything. Now with modifiers, I have a set system. Control itself as a button is only to do with tracks. Alt is only to do with items. And the Apple, if you're old fashioned, or the command is more than or buses, an expansion thereof. So Control 1 is showing me just the tracks. Alt 1 is showing me just the tracks with audio on and zooming the audio. And Command 1 is just showing me the bus. Let's have a look at this with the acoustic just to reiterate. So 3 is the overview. Control and 3 is just the tracks, including tracks I haven't recorded onto yet. And Alt 3 is just the itemed tracks and they're zoomed in. And Command 3 is the buses on their own. If you've got a time selection, the time selection will override because assuming that's where you're working. So always it will go to the time selection first. Right, light yourself a smelly candle, take a sip of whiskey, do whatever you do. Programming does my head in, but here we go. First of all, let's create 6 tracks. Now we'll multiply name those tracks. Anything that I do here or in other videos, I'll put links to give you more of an explanation of how to do that. So this is the first name. The kits is really relevant, so this appears with other drums. So that abbreviation of the name is important there. So I've got a master drum track that everything comes into, the clean out bus. That then sends pre-fader to the comp out bus, and it sends pre-fader to the drive out bus. This way you only need to route your drums down into one track, the clean out bus. Those 3 are going to sum into the kit out bus. So my whole kit, volume and saturation, compression, all of that, the volume is controlled on there. There's a music out bus, so I can balance the music with the drums before it goes into the final master out bus. I never do anything with Reaper's master output whatsoever. The master out is all dealt with on this final track. And this is kind of where we're heading. Let's stick a compressor on there. The preset is slamming. Same with the tape drive, that's slamming. Volumes are right down. Never listen to my drums through the clean. And then when I think, well, okay, I want to add some parallel compression or some drive, I'm blending with faders. I'm not going into the plugins at all. I'm literally just moving these three faders to get the tone I like. If it's too loud or too quiet, there's my overall volume control for the kit. So the clean, comp, and drive are all summing down into the kit outbus. The kit outbus and the music outbus into the master out. Okay, back to where we were. Highlight all of the tracks. Hold the Alt key and click on the IO label. That toggles the master send on and off. So it's off there, that's why it's red. Select the first three tracks. Opposite click on the IO label of one of them and send them to the kit outbus. Another way you can do this is if you hold on the IO label and drag, you'll see a jack appear. Put that down to the master out from the kit out and the music out bus. Okay, that's routed now. So if you look at the clean out, that's going post fader to the kit. That's fine. Its volume will affect what gets sent. Let's also send to the comp out and the drive out, but we want these to be either pre-effects or pre-fader, post-effects. I tend to use things pre-fader, post-effects. If I'm going to EQ one, I'll probably want the EQ to affect all the others. So adjusting this volume, the clean-out bus volume, does not affect the signal going to the comp-out or the drive-out. They are pre-fader. It does affect the signal going to the kit-out, because that's post-fader. Now the intention is to save this all as a track template shortly, so let's do some things to it, like colour it and stick some icons on it. I usually use red for drums. Give that some kind of blue. Make that white. Add whichever icons you like to use. If you're not sure how to do that, I'll put a link to the video for that. And make sure this master out, this final track, is going to the master send. Make sure that's ticked, or it's going nowhere. Run the volumes down of the comp and drive out. And let's put, however you do this, I'm doing it like this, put a compressor on that channel. I've got a setup for that. I might adjust the threshold, depends on the signal coming to it, obviously, but make sure the attack is as short as possible, release as long as possible, and the mix on full. Similar kind of concept with the drive. You can really hammer it. Because you're going to blend these with faders, it's going to be quite an easy thing for you to do to get a nice sound or a nice mix of these three things very quickly. So highlight them all, right click, and go to Save as Track Templates. I made this folder within the Track Templates folder and then subdivided everything up into things that I use. So this is the output bus. I'm calling it Drums Music Master. If you wanted, you could save items or envelopes. I've got neither in this. Now don't delete anything. Right click in the space, templates. You can either open template and find the folder, or the folder will exist here. Select it. Menus are okay for testing and stuff, but remember, I want to get you onto using a button. So it's just simply click, click, and there's your track template. There are three or four custom actions we need to make for the final custom action. So let's get on with that. Open your action list, new action, new custom action. I'll highlight that and edit it. This will look blank for you, but type in the name there and copy it. Might be useful for later. And these actions I've already got, where yours will be empty. Type the words in into the left-hand filter till the exact action appears in the left-hand box. Just drag it over. Keep doing that till you've built up those four actions there. When you've done that, OK it. You can paste the name into the filter at the top there. Action comes up. Then click on Add and add whichever hotkey you want. I use the numberpad forward slash or command numberpad forward slash. I use a few for that. And close that. That's the first one done. the second action we'll do, new action, new custom action, is unselect all. While I quickly get that up from my list. You'll have nothing in these boxes again, so give it this name in the custom action name and copy that. Type the name that you see in the right-hand box into the filter. That will produce that in the left-hand box below for you to drag over or double-click. Just make sure they are exactly the right actions in exactly the right order. If they don't come up for you, you might not have the SWS extensions installed or the rear pack. You need both of those. So if there are any actions missing, it will be for that reason. Okay. So highlight that and add. Have Command and U, and then add U as the two hotkeys. You can have more than one hotkey for each command. Can be useful. Okay, this is going to be the last one. New action, new custom action. I'll find it. It's called Arrange Window Main. I'll edit it so you can see what the custom actions are. So give it the custom action name, Arrange Window Main. Select all and copy that. These actions below, just copy the words into the filter as per. Make sure it's exactly the right one. And drag them all across in the right order. Arrange Window Main doesn't have a hotkey. It tends to be used as a custom action within other custom actions. And obviously, containing as many actions as it does, that's very time saving to be able to insert that into other actions. It's in quite a few of them. That's basically why we've had to set this up this way so far. Okay, we're very nearly there. All we need to do is open the cycle action editor. So open your action list and we'll make a hotkey for that now. Search cycle action. Find open close cycle action editor. I'm using Shift J. It's a toggle, so it'll open and close this window. So let's run and close. And there's the cycle action window. I don't utilize this to the extent a lot of people do. Keep it simple, you'll be glad to hear. If you opposite click anywhere, I know it's going to highlight something, it doesn't matter. Opposite click and add cycle action, you'll be able to create a new one. Right, let's go back to the template we've made so far. Click on Clean Out Bus Kits, copy that. Shift J to open the cycle actions. I'll just clean the filter there, empty the filter. Okay, in this left-hand side where everything begins with the word console, it didn't need to. That's actually part of what goes in the command on the other side. I just find it easier to check because of the space on the left-hand side. So it could just be called Toms or whatever. But I'm doing it this way and I'll show you this way. It doesn't do any harm. So opposite click. Add cycle action. Type console, capital C. Space, capital S, star. Now paste the action in. Yep, there's a little space there. That's fine. It wouldn't be fine if the spacing was wrong from there on in. It's okay to begin with though. Encapsulate that with another star. Highlight it all. Copy it. Press return. Okay, over to the right hand side to the command. Do what it says. Right click or opposite click on your mouse. Add. And just paste into that, press return. And apply, bottom left hand corner. So now if you click on action list, you'll be able to find that in your action list. Just paste again. So there's the original one below where it didn't have a gap. And the new one I've just made that does. So how do we incorporate that into a custom action that shows us these tracks? Well, we need to make another custom action. I promise it's the last one today. So, action list, new action, new custom action. I'll quickly find the shortcut and show you what that is. So you'll have empty boxes. Type custom action name. Make sure it's this name or something similar. It doesn't have to be perfect, but this is the name I'm using. Copy it. Now, type into the filter these actions. So to start with, arrange window main. You've just made that. Drag that across, that'll have custom in front of it because you've made that. And then Console S, that's another one you've made. Find that, clean out bus. You've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Select next tracks, keep in current selection. Hide the unselected tracks, vertical zoom to those tracks. Select the first track and scroll to the top. If that isn't highlight, the one that you've been working on, sometimes it isn't, you can still just type that into the filter. That's why I keep copying it from the name so I don't lose it. And give it this shortcut, 0. There are two buttons or opportunities to delete an action and only one to actually copy and save it, so be really careful. These are right next to each other, so it's easily done. Duplicate your custom action. Make sure you've got a backup of it. For the CSI, let's copy the selected action command ID. Close this window. Okay, open your preferences window. Go down to Control over C Web. Double click this and just leave that there. And into the Reaper resources folder, you'll find your CSI folder. Into zones, I'm using the MCU. So I'll open the MCU zone. This is mid-March 2021, so the latest one at this time. And I'm going to assign this to output. So there's outputs, no action. I'm going to highlight that and delete that and type Reaper with a capital R, space. And I'm going to paste that command ID in, space, a couple of forward slashes, and then describe it there. So save this, and you can quit that. Close that. And all you need to do is press return, return, and that's updated. So choose some different kind of view, and then press 0. You should be coming back to that every time. And then when I press outputs on the Mackie, I've got the outputs. Right, if you haven't burnt your house down with the amount of smelly candles and sage wafting you've done to stay chilled, well done. I can tell you that for the other 9 actions, it's probably going to take about 5 minutes apiece. We've done a lot of extra stuff here, so I hope it's been useful, and I hope you tune in for the others and you get your whole controller running, or all of your hotkeys running this way. Okay, thanks for watching.